The report called for South Africa's criminal justice system to recognize the rapes as hate crimes in an attempt to force police to take action over the rising tide of violence. So the police don't even have your back. The police will not even protect these women from a violent act. And why? Because it's women. Because it's just women. And not only that, they're just lesbians. So F them, right? The ferocity of the attack became clear in April last year when Udi Simelane, former star of South Africa's national female football squad, became one of the victims. Ms. Simelane, an equality and equality rights campaigner and one of the first women to live openly as a lesbian, was gang raped and brutally beaten before being stabbed 25 times in the face, chest, and legs. But scores more women have been deliberately targeted for rape, The Guardian reports. Every day I am told that they are going to kill me, that they are going to rape me, and after they rape me, I'll become a girl. When you are raped, you have a lot of evidence on your body. But when we try and report these crimes, nothing happens. And then you see the boys who raped you walking free on the street. Research shows 86% of black lesbians in the Western Cape live in fear of sexual assault. Triangle, a gay rights organization, said it deals with up to 10 new cases of corrective rape every week. Every week. Can you imagine? All you want to do is live openly, live freely, live how you want to live, however that is. And you're so afraid because you just might be raped that day. It says, what we're seeing is a spike in the numbers of women coming to us having been raped and who have been told through the attack that being a lesbian was to blame for what was happening to them. Support groups claim that an increasing macho political environment led to interaction over the attacks. A statement released by South Africa's National Prosecuting Authority said, while hate crimes, especially of a sexual nature, are rife, it is not something that the South African government has prioritized as a specific project. Human rights and equality campaigners are hoping that the public outrage and disgust at Ms. Simelane's death and the jury trial of the three men accused of her rape and murder will help put an end to the spiraling violence. So I say to the parent, what was the name of this organization again? Because now, to the Parents Television Council, and to anybody who thought that Rihanna's video was too violent for TV, this is reality. This is a reality of life. And thank goodness that she brought it to light. Because I am saying, and I don't care who has a problem with it, I am saying that every woman everywhere around the world, I don't care what you are, I don't care what race you are, this transcends any prejudices that I may have. I'm saying to any woman, every woman, arm yourself. Arm yourself with whatever you think you can handle. Not every woman can handle a gun. And I would say to any woman who cannot handle a gun, don't carry one. Don't carry one because it will only be to your detriment if you are afraid to use it. but to every woman that is not afraid to handle a gun and knows how to handle a gun, carry it. Because there's no telling when you might have to use it. And use it if you have to. Especially to the women in South Africa, to the women in Congo, to the women all over the African continent who this is happening to and nobody gives a rat's ass about you. Care enough about yourself. Care enough about yourself to protect yourself.